together with you.
DuVernay return a kick 93 yards for a touchdown against the Chiefs. Lamar Jackson time. How about the best one-loss records by a quarterback through 33 starts since 1970? Kurt Warner, Dan Marino, Patrick Mahomes. Can hold everything. Oh. Lamar Jackson in the house in a big way. Nice pocket for Jackson. Breaks down. He nearly slipped down again. There is a flag that has come out. Jackson has first down yardage. But we'll check the marker. Jay Stewart. Here's first down and 10. Pressure. Jackson nearly slipped down again. Now trying to run away from people, and he's got that wide receiver speed. And he'll pick up the necessary yardage. Ran away from Olivier Vernon for 13.
Here's the rush right here. There's going to be a lane going that way. And it's very hard on for four guys, three guys rushing. You see they're trying to maintain the perimeter on the outside and not let him get to the outside. He'll just go straight up the middle, and Olivier Vernon's not catching him.
Great coverage down the field that time by the Browns, but that's what Lamar does, right? He's a neutralizer. He just equalizes everything.
First down and 10. Jackson nearly slipped down again. Keeps it, and he's wrestled out of bounds by Carl Joseph. Card in the slot, too. Third and 3. Keeper. Lamar Jackson, touchdown Ravens.
Kick out on Myles Garrett. That's the key right there. And then you get a little bit of a crease for Orlando Brown up in the hole. And a touchdown for Lamar Jackson.
Yeah, there was a little miscommunication with B.J. Goodson trying to get it going forward.
Second and 6 off the play fake. Jackson has all sorts of time. And Lamar's going to run out of there now. Pick up the first down. Out to the 45-yard line.
In the pocket. You know, where do you want him to go with this ball? They're dropping in the middle of the field. And this is Joe Woods. It's a strategy by Cleveland and part of the developing book on Lamar Jackson.
Although both teams are playing on it, the Browns don't seem to have an issue. But Lamar Jackson's been slipping and sliding all over the field tonight.
The cleat selection on cold nights like this, when the grass is cut real short, it's just critical because you have to pick just the right ones. You can't have them too long, otherwise you don't get enough grip. You can't have them too short, otherwise you're just skating along the top of the grass.
Jackson will keep it and get the end into the red zone and knocked out at the 11-yard line. A 20-yard rush for Lamar Jackson.
Where they want to run the football, because he's the guy you see in there. He just hooks the edge, and then it's just up to Lamar. When I talked about the fact
Justin
that he's
checked in his place. Second and 9. Jackson surveys the field. Sneed's got it. He juggled it, hauled it in, and has the first and 10. It is the back, Edwards. Turns the corner, lowers the shoulder, and got there. Touchdown. Third and 10. They've only taken 9 seconds off the clock. Here's Jackson in some trouble. Running into his own players. Had a man wide open, and it's Mark Andrews. Welcome to the game, Mark Andrews.
Not go to Mark Andrews. If the other receivers are dropping the ball, Lewis, this is his security blanket.
I'll tell you, he's just blocking them, releasing as a security valve out here, and then he sees his quarterback in trouble, just leaks down the sideline. I mean, that's just killer for a defense. You do everything right. Mark Andrews is thinking, hey, maybe the play's over. Oh, maybe it's not. Let me just run down here. MJ Stewart loses track of him. That just
game's thigh injury and on the COVID-19 reserve list. Jackson takes off. So much green in front of him for the Lamar Jackson touchdown. There is a penalty marker down.
It's going to be a touchdown. They're going to get to the Brown secondary with a hold. Okay, watch this. This is Carl Joseph. He's going to follow the tight end, and that's going to leave a huge lane for Lamar Jackson. This is a pass. He's looking downfield, doesn't see it. But when you play man-to-man against an athlete like Lamar and you don't have your lanes, he's going to be throwing it into the dog pound.
Jackson will keep it. Lamar Jackson cuts it up. Look at the speed by Lamar Jackson. Well over 100 yards rushing for the game.
The adjustment was at halftime. That is not it, okay? You don't want to give Lamar Jackson that much green grass, Lewis.
Look, you see what's happening. They're playing man-to-man coverage, and that's just not fair. Look, Myles Garrett's one of the best athletes in the NFL. But when he has, when he's being read like this by a guy who runs zone read better than anyone in the NFL, you know he's going to take the option that best suits him, and then it's just off to the races.
And that's usually the ball follows him.
Off the play fake. Across the middle. It is caught. Richardson had the big stop on Derrick Henry on 4th-and-1 a week ago. Here's Jackson trying to get out of there. He'll take on some people and took a big shot. On 3rd-and-7, got it in there. Mark Andrews right at the sticks.
Lamar Jackson, and give him this amount of time to find Mark Andrews. And what do we talk about? Where does he like to throw the ball on third down? In the middle of the field.
Steve, I'm now being told that Lamar Jackson is back in the Ravens locker room being treated for cramps. His return is questionable. The backup, Trace McSorley, was over here warming up. He is now in the game under center for the Ravens.
Trace gonna keep it, and he slips down.
And Trace hurt his left knee there. He went down really awkward. And if no Trace McSorley and Lamar Jackson in the locker room, I don't know who the third quarterback's gonna be.
It's a loss of 3 on the play.
You see him try and plant his right foot. And right there, it gives out. That left knee just buckles.
Wow, what a spot for the Ravens. And here comes Lamar Jackson. It's got a go Willis Reed reference, but I might lose some of the audience there. Like Superman running out of the locker room without the cape. While McSorley's attended to, Lamar comes in for 4th-and-5. Trailing by a point. Jackson trying to throw for it, and he's got it. Marquise Brown hangs onto the football and scores. How do you like that? Tremendous. Without the cape, Jackson rushes back in to save the Ravens. And looking like he's going to run forward, he throws it to Marquise Brown, who's dropped 3 passes tonight. He's got a chance to be the hero.
They tried to come up onto Lamar Jackson, and Marquise Brown, after those drops you mentioned, wide open for the touchdown.
Yeah, how many times have we talked about on previous broadcasts? That's Olivier Vernon trying to get out there to cover the back. And when you have bunch formations like that, if you don't get on different levels and you don't play with vision, you'll pick your buddy off. And that's exactly what happened. Just a lot of congestion. Olivier Vernon, in an unfamiliar circumstance, isn't used to working through traffic like that. That's what you get, a big explosive play.
Minute 51 to go. It is Dobbins, got there. 2-point conversion is good.
You get your quarterback who's in the locker room to come out.
A little bit of everything.
I mean, enough storylines here.
And the faith he had in Brown to go back to him after the earlier drops. And you see Dez Bryant, we knew he'd be tweeting from home. Superman showed up right on time. And here he comes.
Dun, 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 dun.
At the 2-minute warning, after McSorley had already gone down. And those defensive backs, you're right, they're in no man's land. They've got to come up to stop the run.
It just puts you in the worst possible situation, Steve. I mean, it really does. You see him coming out there with green grass. It's just, it's awful.
64 ticks, 1 timeout left for Baltimore. Jackson patient in the pocket underneath. It's Mark Andrews. First down, he's out to the 39.
Tackling.
And the hustle of the line.
It's all going to be about tackling right here, Steve. This is where the Browns have to get people on the ground. Yards after the catch are going to get you beat.
It's Andrews again across midfield.
And a quick timeout from John Harbaugh. That was exactly what the Baltimore Ravens needed to do. Back-to-back great throws from Lamar Jackson. You could tell he was just going to find Mark Andrews wherever he was and get him the
football that time. Watching Trace McSorley. First down and 10. Cross for Snead. Inbounds.
You got to get up and clock it.
Justin Tucker's career long is 61. Hit a 55-yarder earlier this season. It's Andrews again. 16 seconds, got to get to the line. Can't stop the clock. 7 seconds remaining. This is for 55. For the win. And Justin Tucker has done it for Baltimore. There are 2 seconds left on the clock. There are a whole lot of heroes tonight in white and purple.
That guy is an absolute sniper when it comes to kicking that football between the uprights.
Barriers for them, and everybody was counting them out. Said they couldn't do it. They haven't looked the same on offense as they did a year ago. And Lamar Jackson came out and played a whale of a football game, as did Baker Mayfield. They both did. They put on a show in primetime, and it looks like Baker may come up a little bit short.
I'll tell you this. There are no consolation prizes. There are no, you know, a win's a win, a loss is a loss, but this is a different Cleveland Browns
team. Two? Yeah, I was just saying.
It's Lamar Jackson.
That was the first pass out of the locker room. Well, that was earlier in the game, but, you know, he came out running in the first half, Lewis, and it was very hard to stop.
Look, and here he comes, da-da-da-da, to the rescue. I mean, it's just amazing. What a great performance by a gutsy, gutsy competitor. Marquise Brown, all night long, we said he's got to catch the football.
Safety. After all that.
And that's how it should end.
Wow.
The signal for the safety.
Be surprised at all if they see each other again in the playoffs.
Baker looks mentally drained, just exhausted.
You can feel the energy that was, you know, that was put forth by both of these football teams up here in this booth. The fans were into it. The players played their hearts out from a physical and a mental perspective, back and forth, the emotional back and forth. This is what makes the NFL so great.